It's time to put our ship printer control room and upgrades to use and go back to the pirate-filled asteroids to gather some more resources. Because we're going to need as many resources as we can carry to build our new space station. But as you'll see, the best laid plans don't always work out. And in this episode, I work around some of my build shortcomings and fix some major oversights in my space engineer shenanigans. I need to start setting up this whole mothership and minor operation with better defenses and some more firepower. Because let's face it, this mothership has so many critical components and items exposed, it's in no way set up for even a modest exchange of firepower. But I'll arm it to the teeth, and maybe I can give it and my miner a fighting chance. So it was time to use my 3D printer and control room again to produce a small army of little drones that I'd be able to use in a variety of ways. So in the control seat, time to build one of my very compact and very cheap to build hydrogen combat drones. Okay, that went perfectly, and the ability to spin the projection was exactly what I needed. It was here, though, that I suddenly realized a major flaw in my plans. The hydrogen drone was hydrogen-powered, and sitting on my printer array, it had no way to fuel itself with hydrogen. As soon as I cut the thing away from the base, it'll just start to fall to the ground, and I'll have to physically move it to a connector or something to get it fueled. I had options. I could build on a series of conveyor tubes and connect it to my mothership's supply. I could even build a crane to do it, but that seemed pretty awful, and I didn't want to have to do it every time. But I had to figure out something. So, okay, for now, I just shore up the base to stabilize it so it wouldn't fall over when I cut it loose. And yes, there may have been a little trial and error with the learning of that the hard way, but the idea, for now, was to move it using the magnetic landing gear on my heavy fighter, and at least get it over to a connector, fueled up and out of the way. It would work, although I wanted something a little more elegant and easily sustainable for future drones. I even considered adding a mag plate to my welder drone, but I decided to just leave that build all alone for now. In the last episode, you saw me put these two side connectors on each side of my mining ship. My plan for that was this. I'd attach one of my combat drones to each side of the miner. Then, when I go out to space, if, or should I say when, the space pirates attack, I could leave them attached and use them as extra firepower with what is also a much greater area of coverage around the ship. Or detach them. Let them hang out in space a little ways from my miner to work as a first line of defense, or even take control of a drone and try to maneuver it and fight with it remotely from my miner. Either way, I figured it was a good plan. With it all fueled up, I just fly this drone over to my mining ship and attach it to the side, then figure out a better way to get my hydrogen-powered drones fueled while still sitting on the projector. One thing I realized right away was that I wouldn't be able to bring up any kind of conveyor tube directly from the bottom from below the ship because my pistons were in the way. So I cut a channel in the deck to bring piping over from the side. Now, here's where things got interesting. I knew I needed several things. A way to convert large grid to small grid, a rotor to spin the image, a small projector, and a connector with conveyor piping for all the hydrogen, and all centered so it would spin on an axis. What I started with was a hinge, and I went through a couple configurations. In the end, it almost seemed like I didn't need the hinge, but it actually was helpful to give the pistons below the needed clearance, though I could have just used a regular elbow conveyor in hindsight. Next, a large grid rotor, where I could grind out the head and replace it with the small head. And from there, attach one of those fairly new small grid conversion conveyors. From here, it was some lateral tubes up to the right height to place another conversion conveyor so I'd have the larger small grid opening to stack on the small grid connector. What I could do is place a small projector underneath in the center and spin the whole thing around while being welded. This looked pretty good, but it did run into the large grid projector and made a funny gear-like spinning thing when it was contacted. I think if I had tried to do that, I'd never have gotten it to work. But in any case, I didn't want anything banging into other things, so a little rework was needed. All I needed to do was bring the tubes in a bit and could keep the overall design. This next test worked well, and in a way, I actually liked this whole design better than the prior setup, where I had the hinge hanging off the side of the large grid projector with a tiny small projector sitting on top. This looked a lot more natural, like it was supposed to be built this way. With the blueprint image in place on top, I just needed a small line of half blocks to the first buildable part of the image, and it was time to weld. It was very satisfying to see the readout on my intelligent LCD displays, showing me blocks being welded and in various states of construction. And in no time, the drone was built. I connected the connectors, locked it in place, and it didn't work. No hydrogen was flowing into the drone. I'll spare you the extensive testing and frustration that went on. And I even went as far as to disconnect the whole upper apparatus between the rotor base and the rotor head to really get in there and figure out what was wrong. But in the end, it was a misplaced reinforced conveyor tube I had in the channel I had made, and I was able to fuel the drone and attach it to the other side of the miner, just like I did the first one. So lots of mistakes were made, but the biggest oversights were yet to come. On my miner I redesigned in my last episode, I was really happy with all the upgrades. But in my enthusiasm to put in all the additions, I forgot to put back my forward thrusters. Yeah, a big mistake. So I thought, maybe, as a simple solution, I could put the thrusters back into the corner areas where there was a connection point and make it work. But I suspected my new Gatling turrets might get damaged. So in a test, I left one in place and spaced the other one off a block, then got into the cockpit and hit the thrusters. Now, I know I've already said it, but the intelligent displays again were able to show me that the turret closest to the thruster was getting damaged. That was bad. But the good news is that the one spaced off a block was fine. So that was the plan. Extend the rear of the ship one block, and in the process, fix another mistake I had made in the design. I wanted to control the little combat drones from the mining ship, but it had no antenna. So I needed one. Now, here was the rub. Those large grid antennas are huge. There was no way I was going to get that giant long antenna on this miner without major concessions. And the dish-shaped antenna was completely out of the question. My only choice was a conversion to a small grid antenna. It was a shame since I'd spent all that effort removing the complex small grid turret array before, but one little component of a small grid I could live with. At the same time though, I could also place another semi-forgotten component, which was a remote control block. So I'd have the option of controlling the whole miner from the mothership. And I had really wanted to install a couple more vertical thrusters, now that I had added more containers and could carry a lot more weight. So after a fair bit of arranging of components and flipping blocks around, it was time to put my welding drone to work and get this thing put back together. So there it is. The miner is just like it was, but with even more utility. The only thing it needs to make it proper is a name change to match the additional cargo containers, and we're all the way up to 36. I'm really pleased with this ultimate miner, and in addition to its self-sustainability that was added in the last video, it has so much carrying capacity now, it could also serve as a really capable cargo hauler for economy missions. Next steps will be to test this updated miner in a long-haul mining run and get ready to launch a mod I'll talk about next time that'll really ratchet up the enemy AI combat quantity, power, and aggressive behavior. So I'm really excited to talk about that and launch a giant space station build. Plus, I've got a Star Citizen ship review coming, and I'm going to be starting the Long Dark Survival series. So there's a lot happening here on this channel. Like and subscribe so you don't miss it. And I'll be talking to you later.